Hello friends, today we are going to study about the awards which are given in India. Awards which are given in India. If we look into civilian awards, the highest civilian award given in India is Bharat Ratna. And the highest military award is Paramveer Chakra. So, first of all, we will talk about this Bharat Ratna. This, as I say, is the highest civilian award. And this was started in 1954. This date you need to remember, sometimes they ask when it was started. Then we can see that in a single year it can be only given to 3 persons, not more than that. The names are recommended by the Prime Minister to the President. These awards are conferred for the exceptional service or performance of highest order. And this is done without any distinction of race, occupation, position or sex. When one receives this Bharat Ratna, he will receive a sanad. Sanad is a certificate signed by the president. Then they will also receive a medallion, and sometimes it's asked in question papers that what is the shape of this medallion. The medallion is shaped in the form of a people leaf. Then sometimes it is also asked that is it providing some monetary benefit or not. So there is no monetary benefit. And when we read Constitution, we know this thing as well, that under Article 18 of Indian Constitution, we say that everybody is equal. And hence, Bharat Ratna's title cannot be used by the people before their name. So, it is being an award, it is not the title which is conferred to the people. It is not a title, it is only an award. Now it should be seen that who were the recipients of this award. As I already told you, 1954 was the first year when these awards were given. So it was given to three people. First was C. Raj Gopalachari. Now C. Raj Gopalachari is also the last Governor General of India. He is also the first Indian Governor General. He also became Governor of West Bengal, and he was also a CM of erstwhile Madras. I'll tell you one thing, that Madras was at that point of time consisting of present day Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. The second person who got this award was Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan. Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan. He was the first Vice President of India. He was also the second President of India. And he is the person in whose memory we celebrate Teachers' Day. the third person to whom this prize was given was C.V. Raman. C.V. Raman is a scientist. He got Nobel Prize in 1930. This Nobel Prize was given to him for Raman effect. This Raman effect is related to light scattering. And he was the one who explained why water appears to be blue. Now a question may also arise that was this prize given posthumously. What is the meaning of this posthumously? That is after death. What we in Hindi we call as marnoparant. So this prize is also given posthumously. And the first person who got this prize posthumously was Lal Bahadur Shastri, who was second PM of India after Sri Jawaharlal Nehru, and he died in Tashkent. Another question may come to your mind, that is this prize given to the people who are not the citizen of this country? So the answer is yes, it is given to them. And the best example for this is Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan. He is also called Frontier Gandhi, and the people who supported him or his group were called Red Shirts, and his own group was called Khudai Khidmatgar. He was a part of Indian National Movement. And secondly, the foreign national who got this prize was Nelson Mandela, and his nickname is Madiba, and he is remembered for a very good leadership when South Africa got independence from white people, and then he did a great work in following the Gandhian principles and brought all the people together in a rainbow coalition government in order to govern his own country in a better manner. Last year in 2016 and 17, these prizes were not given. But in the 2015 year, this prize was given to two people. One was Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and the second was Madan Mohan Malviya. And before that, in 2014, this prize was given to the god of cricket, that is Sachin Tendulkar, and second was C.N.R. Rao. This person is also a very famous scientist. He studies solid state chemistry. So this is all about what we know about Bharat Ratna. But then there are few other civilian awards which are also given in India, which are called Padma Awards. Padma Awards. And the highest of the Padma Award is Padma, Vibhushan. Below that is Padma Bhushan. And the bottom most is Padma Shri. Out of these three, we are only going to talk about Padma, Vibhushan, which were given in January 2018. These prizes were given to three people. One was Ilaiya Raja. Second was Ghulam Mustafa Khan. And third was P. Paramaneshwaran. Ilaiya Raja is a film composer. This Ghulam Mustafa is a Indian classic musician. And you should also know about his gharana, that is Rampur Sahaswan gharana. Rampur Sahaswan gharana. And this P. Parameshwaram is Hindu thinker and RSS ideologue in Kerala. So all these people got Padma Vibhushan awards this year. These are the latest Padma Vibhushan awards. We are not going to talk about other Padma awards because these are given to many of the people, and thus the chances of questions are very less. But the questions regarding Bharat Ratna and Padma Vibhushan are quite high. So we need to remember whom were it given to and what are the categories of these of the fields from which these people come. So we know that Ilaiya Raja he is a film composer or is a music composer in South Indian movies. Ghulam Mustafa Khan is an Indian classic musician who is from Rampur Sahaswan gharana, and this P. Parameshwaram is a Hindu thinker and RSS ideologue in Kerala. So this is it about the Bharat Ratna and Padma awards. But I'll also make another part to it with various other awards which are given to India and which are very important for these exams. Thank you.